Skylar Howard in West Virginia sit just on the cusp of a top 25 ranking. Today, the unbeaten Mountaineers welcome border rival Maryland to Morgantown. And we welcome you to the AT&T Fox College Football pregame show. Welcome inside our Fox College Football studios here in Los Angeles. Rob Stone, Matt Leiner, Dave Wonstadt with you. Thanks for joining us here on FS2. The Maryland-West Virginia kickoff scheduled for 3:10 Eastern. That's in about 10 minutes' time. Once the truck race is finished on FS1, we will immediately take you out to Maryland-West Virginia. Let's get you involved and set up for that one right now. And if you're taking on West Virginia, you're taking on a unique defense, Coach.
Well, you are. And they're going to have to rely on their defense. You know, when you graduate from last year's offense, Clint Trickett, you lose Kevin White, some high-profile players for you, your defense is going to have to pick up the load this year, as we say. And last year, they made a change. They went with Tony Gibson, longtime Rich Rodriguez assistant. He came in, he implemented the 3-3-5 defense. Mm-hmm. We talked about that. And they cut their, they went 7 points, they gave up 7 points less a game a year ago. So they were, they established the foundation. This year, they're leading the Big 12 in scoring defense and leading the Big 12 in total defense. So defense right now is kind of where West Virginia is making
it. We're not used to seeing that. Usually it's the offense.
You're right.
West Virginia.
You're right.
And I'll tell you what, with Maryland's quarterback Caleb Rowe getting the start again today, 5 interceptions so far, Rob, and 37 pass attempts. He has to do a better job protecting the football, especially against that 3-3-5 right. defense. I've played against it. It is difficult. They cannot afford to turn the ball over in this game and give it to Skylar Howard and the West Virginia offense.
Taking a quick highlight right now on the fourth Saturday of the season, and bit of a surprising result right now. Number 8, LSU and Leonard Fournette up 7 in the third at Syracuse. 62-yard touchdown run from Fournette. They also had a punt return taken to the house. They're starting to open this one up a little bit, but since 24-17, Syracuse hanging tough. Fournette, you get the expectations and the hype has kind of been growing over the last 2 weeks or so, and then he does this again. Is he the Heisman frontrunner?
I'd say right now he is, Coach, and I know you may disagree with me. Back-to-back 200-yard rushing games in the SEC. He's a great back, and when you talk about winning the Heisman Trophy, you have to win football games. They are so far. You know, they have to continue to win. Those moments, Coach, we talk about. He had some moments last week against Auburn that your jaw dropped. He's doing it again today against Syracuse. He's the most dominant football player right now in college football, in my opinion.
Just because he has a vote for the Heisman doesn't mean he's the authority.
And what I like about voting for quarterbacks.
Wait,
I like this
no,
guy.
No, well, you didn't mention it. What about Nick Chubb? You know what? Hey, how about your Cody Kessler from USC? I know they got beat last week. 78% completion. My man Connor Cook from Michigan State. I mean, you know, no, he's putting up his 65% completion. I mean, Trevon Boykin.
I love
TCU.
Trevon Boykin. He's my guy. He's my guy.
Well, who's won?
TCU and Trevon Boykin on Fox a little bit later today. They take on Texas Tech, Oregon, Utah. That one also on Fox.
He's one play.
We remind you, Maryland, West Virginia, it's going to start right here on FS2. As soon as the race is over on FS1, we're immediately going to take our coverage over there. So hang with us for the next couple minutes on FS2, and then FS1 will take over. Again, West Virginia unbeaten. They need to get through this game, and then it's 4 straight ranked opponents on their schedule. Okay. They need to get to 3-0 and then try and manage what's next on their schedule. For Maryland, sitting at 2-1, an underrated rivalry game right now, West Virginia and Maryland. We start on FS2. We move it over to FS1. Now out to the game, the two calling it for you, Justin Kutcher, Petros Papadakis.
It is a great day for football here in Morgantown, West Virginia. 60,000 people expected here at Milan Pushkar Stadium. A gold rush and a rivalry game. It's so big, Brad Paisley's in town getting them fired up. Welcome to FS1 College Football presented by GEICO. And hello to everybody. Justin Kutcher alongside Petros Papadakis. And Petros, for West Virginia, a different type of quarterback this year under a Dana Holgorsen-type team. Skylar Howard, he's a zone read guy.
Yeah, you're used to seeing a Geno Smith type, right? Stands back there and really distributes the ball to skilled players. Skylar Howard is a little bit different. Now, he can throw the football, make no mistake. But this is a guy who's had a wacky route here to Morgantown. Junior college in California. Here's a guy from Fort Worth, Texas. He won wants to play against Big 12 competition. That's why Holgorsen got him. And this will be a different look. He runs the ball. He's got a chip on his shoulder, only about 6 feet tall. Can't wait to see him in a big game.
As far as Maryland is concerned, Caleb Rowe, their quarterback, got the start last year. Last week, his first since 2013, will start again today. The problem for him, he has to go up against this West Virginia secondary.
Yeah, this is a defensive look for the West Virginia Mountaineers team, and that's different for Dana Holgorsen. They have a great secondary, and Caleb Rowe is going to try to test him. He throws the ball down the field, a lot of arm talent. They say he can really spin it, but a quarter of his passes are either a pick or a touchdown. So feast or famine with this guy. That has a guy like Carl Joseph, the great safety, all Big 12 for West Virginia, drooling for a pick this afternoon.
Well, this is a rivalry that goes back to 1919. West Virginia won last year. They're trying to make it back-to-back. The 52nd all-time meeting is next here on FS1. Moments ago, the Mountaineers took the field here at Milan Puskás Stadium. The crowd is ready for them. And then the Maryland Terrapins in this rivalry matchup, the 52nd all-time meeting between these two schools. Last year, it was West Virginia winning 40-37. What do we have in store today? They first met back in 1919, but 2013, Petros, Dana Holgorsen says that loss, one of the worst, if not the worst, of his career.
Yeah, 37-0, they really wore it out in the big stadium in Baltimore where the Ravens play. And Holgorsen has not forgotten it. They got the victory last year, but it's great to see this rivalry still being played, especially with the backyard brawl with West Virginia and Pitt is no longer played because of conference realignment. It's great to see these two teams from big conferences getting together.
Holgorsen in his fifth year, Randy Edsall, the head coach of Maryland, in his fifth year as the head coach of the Terps, his 16th overall, spent time at UConn as well. You could not have a better day for football here in Morgantown. 76 degrees, barely any humidity. The sun was out, now some clouds in the sky. But they are ready for this because, really, if you think about it, for West Virginia, they're 2-0 on the season. They're coming off a bye week. They've beaten Liberty. They beat Georgia Southern. Now they get to play a school from the Big Ten in Maryland. They want to see what they're made of. Dana Holgorsen thinks he could have something special here with this Mountaineer team because they've always been known for offense, but this year it's defense that they make their mark.
Well, they have that 3-3-5 going, obviously made famous by Rich Rod and Castile here in West Virginia, and it got back to that with Tony Gibson, their defensive coordinator. And they better get it together fast. A couple of quick opponents that they took care of. But here you have Maryland. Then you go to Oklahoma. Oklahoma State going to Baylor. It ramps up quickly for the Mountaineers. This will be a great test for them and for the Terps as well.
West Virginia won the toss. They've elected to defer. Nick O'Toole will kick off for the Mountaineers. Back deep is one of the most dangerous return men in the country in William Likely, number 4. The wind blew the ball off the tee.
Not that hard, geez.
I didn't think it was that hard. Maybe it's all these fans just going crazy.
They are excited. That Paisley was pretty good. I'm not even from here, and I have a little tear in my eye about West Virginia.
The Gold Rush, 60,000 strong. O'Toole, the senior from Corona, California, to kick off. Likely 6 yards deep in the end zone. He'll take a knee. How about three things you need to know when Maryland has the ball, P?
Well, they've been up and down this year offensively, and they have been a lot of fun, but they can take the top off, and that's what makes them fun. Laverne Jacobs is one of those guys. They have a lot of talented, not very big wide receivers that they want to get down the field, but they also want to run the ball a little bit better. They've not had the balance they want, and that's basically up to Brandon Ross, who's going to run the ball. And for West Virginia, you talked about it. Georgia Southern, Liberty, prove it against somebody good. Develop your stars. Carl Joseph and the rest of this secondary are going to have a chance to showcase themselves.
Caleb Rowe in the shotgun. Brandon Ross is tailback on first down. Play action. Rowe, we talked about his arm strength, and there's the first pass broken up by K.J. Dillon. That secondary, Dillon, Carl Joseph, so dangerous.
Well, you just said it right there, Justin. He's going to try to throw the ball down the field. Not a bad throw, not bad placement, but one of the better athletes on the West Virginia team, Dillon, able to get to that ball and whap it away.
297 yards last week, 4 touchdowns, 3 interceptions against USF. Brandon Ross takes the toss. Ross gets through and picks up 9 yards. Shaq Pettaway with the tackle. 3rd and 1, and they're going hurry up here. Kept by the quarterback, Rowe, and a flag on the play.
There is no foul on the play. Delay of game warning. The center judge was not in position. Repeat 3rd down.
Guess you can't go with a sneak now.
Well, you could.
Hang on. Pick my back.
But K.J. Dillon's going to see it coming. And that's basically on the officials, so they're going to run it again.
3rd and 1 here for Maryland. Opening series of the game. Rowe under center. This time the handoff. It's Ross, and he gets the 1st down.
That's a big deal for this Maryland offensive line. They're a little bit shuffled around right now. Mike Minter, their starting left guard, is out, meaning Ryan Doyle moves over from right tackle. And to get a 1st down, and then it's called back because of the delay of game warning, and then to do it again where you hand it to your back, get a good push from this O-line, that's a good sign for the Terps early on this drive.
They'd love to get their running attack going in this one against West Virginia. On 1st down, it's Ross again, and Ross gets stuffed. Right away, it's Noble Wachuku at the line, 2nd and 10.
This is a guy that started all 13 games last year, 34 tackles and a couple of sacks, and he got to the backfield early and showed Ross that he was here too.
Play action. Rowe down the middle, incomplete. Daryl Worley there on the coverage. And Petros, you talked about this in the open. As far as Rowe's concerned, he likes to take those chances downfield, but it's almost either a touchdown or interception.
Well, he's one of those guys that has a lot of confidence in his arm. You know, I played with Carson Palmer when he was first at USC. He threw a lot of picks because he had a lot of confidence. It really is a great thing, but it also could be a detriment. Let's see what they do here on 3rd and long.
On 3rd and 10, Rowe stepping up. He's got the opening, and he's got himself the 1st down as he crosses midfield up to the 47 of West Virginia, picks up 15 on 3rd and 10.
Well, Skylar Howard, I guess, is not the only quarterback that can use his legs. Rowe really takes his time and works through his progression. I like that. It makes the decision to tuck it when he sees the field, protects the ball, and gets out of bounds, looking like an experienced quarterback in this game.
Ty Johnson now in at tailback. Play action again. This time Rowe just throws it away, and that shows off his arm strength.
And they want more of that. That's what offensive coordinator Mike Locksley wants. He wants a little bit more savvy from his quarterback. Tucking it and running there, getting out of bounds, protecting the football, throwing that one away where nobody could get it because he can't from that opposite hash.
Right.
That's a good sign for this quarterback.
2nd down and 10. That ball batted down at the line by Eric Kinsey, number 45. 3rd down and 10 coming up once again for Maryland.
Forward and incomplete. 3rd down.
Kinsey's in there on 2nd down because he's generally a run stopper, but he does a great job of recognizing pass and getting that arm up, batting it away.
Two for two on 3rd downs on this drive are the Terps. The handoff to Wes Brown. Brown will be tackled as he crossed the 40 shy of the 1st down marker.
But that was a pretty good game there, Justin, and that makes for a pretty interesting call here on fourth down. What's Randy Ensel going to do? Wes Brown, another back that they're trying to get involved. They say he's got maybe a little bit more to offer than Brandon Ross, but just not as much experience. And here we go.
Randy Ensel going for it here on fourth down. Wes Brown is in there on fourth and one. Rowe, the option pitch to Brown, and Brown gets knocked down at the 39. Carl Joseph there to deliver the hit.
We talked about Joseph, physical run stopper, hard hitter, and a guy, if he puts his hands on you, you're not going to get to the sticks. That's a really sure tackle, and he did a good job there of trying to make a bit of a kill shot, but he wrapped up the leg just enough to get him down. Great play by a great playmaker for this West Virginia defense.
A turnover on downs. Here comes West Virginia. Skylar Howard, the quarterback. Wendell Smallwood splits out wide now. Empty backfield here on first down. Howard, pressured. Trying to turn the corner. He does to pick up a couple of positive yards. How about the three things you need to know with West Virginia has the ball?
Well, you just saw one of them right there with Howard running the ball. Create an identity. Who are you going to be offensively under Dana Holgorsen? Be explosive. Tavon Austin, White. We've seen these guys get down the field. They're going to have to do the same thing.
Second down and eight. The handoff is to Smallwood. Flag on the play. The referee is John O'Neill for today's game.
Offside. Defense number seven. 5 yards from the previous spot. Repeat second down.
That's against Yannick Ngakoue. How about the last of the three things we should know?
Well, handle the pace. And you just saw West Virginia go fast and try to get up to the line of scrimmage quickly, and Maryland could not handle the pace. They had a very difficult time in the second half against Bowling Green when the game got away from them. But Bowling Green played fast. Nobody can play faster than Dana Holgorsen.
After the penalty, second down and three. The handoff to Smallwood, tries to turn the corner, cut it back. And Smallwood looks like he's got enough for that first down. Skylar Howard, the junior, JUCO transfer. A very accurate passer. Here on first down, steps up, nobody's open, buys some time. Again, he tucks it and runs with it, and he gets hit hard right by the sideline by A.J. Hendy. Three flags are thrown right along that sideline.
And they're going to have to look at this as well. Quarterback on the sideline who can run. Always a difficult play for a safety, but a very violent hit. The flag came out. I think they're going to call targeting.
If it is, in fact, targeting, of course, the replay officials will take a further look.
And it did seem like a pretty high tackle.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness, with targeting a defenseless player in the head or neck area. Defense, 15 yards from the end of the run, automatic first down. The ruling is under further review.
Yeah, he's way out of bounds, and it's a hit up above the shoulder pads. This one's going to stand. You see the helmet-to-helmet contact. I don't want to make excuses for Hendy because he really was gunning for him there. But at the same time, here's a running quarterback who's already tiptoed the sidelines and made a play on this drive. You know, here he comes again. But you do have to be smarter, and these are the rules of today in college football. Crown doesn't like it, and I think Hendy's going to be done for the day.
Again, this play right now is under review. You see the Terps last week penalized 12 times for 120 yards. The replay official is Bob Wasedich.
Hendy is a senior from Bowie, Maryland. And obviously a tough guy, and somebody they need as a leader in this secondary. Been at the Maryland program for 5 years. suspended last year for student code of conduct violation. He's probably going to be suspended for this game.
First quarter, no score. West Virginia with the ball. The call, A.J. Hendy, a personal foul targeting. Now, it looks like we're going to have our ruling.
After further review, there was no foul for targeting. However, the unnecessary roughness will be enforced from the dead ball spot, automatic first down.
And I agree with that, because if you see him, it looks like he hit around the shoulder pad area and his head snaps back.
There was helmet to helmet.
I didn't think his helmet touched his helmet.
I think the helmets touched each other. But at the same time, I like the fact that they can relieve suspending a guy, but also enforce the penalty.
Yes.
And that's a nice rule change, and Hendy's going to stay in the game. I still saw the helmet-to-helmet contact there, and the quarterback was on the white out of bounds.
First and 10. The ball is now at the 27-yard line of Maryland. Russell Shell, the tailback. They give it to Shell, makes one guy miss. And then Shell gets wrapped up at the line of scrimmage, no gain. Jermaine Carter with the tackle. Jermaine Carter comes from an athletic family, number 23, his cousins. I would take this guy to dunk contest, Vince Carter and Tracy McGrady. Shell finds the hole, and Shell will get tackled at the 23. Jalen Brooks able to drag him down. Look, he pulled him down by the jersey.
Shell, leading rusher on this team last year. Smallwood got the start. They really use them both a whole bunch. He was 1 year at Pitt, transferred, he said, to UCLA, but ended up in West Virginia, and they're still waiting for him to have a breakout type of season. We'll see if it's coming in 2015.
Third down and 5. Shell splits out in motion. The pass is complete. Dakeel Shorts Jr. with the catch, a 15-yard pickup, first and goal.
And here you see Howard. He's not going to play quarterback for Dana Holgorsen unless he can throw that out route. Pretty good defense by Likely, who's a great corner, but a better play by Shorts. Pulled it in.
Red zone opportunity, first and goal from the 7. 11 straight trips for West Virginia have resulted in points in the red zone. 7 touchdowns, 4 field goals.
There's a fullback in there. You don't see that a lot with Holgorsen teams, Justin.
Bootleg. The pass. Complete. Touchdown. Elijah Wellman. There is a flag in the end zone, but a touchdown for Elijah Wellman. 7-yard pass from Skylar Howard.
Pretty simple with the action going the other way. Fullback leaks out of the flat. Hauls it in. And finds a pylon.
After the play was over, dead ball, personal foul, number 78 on the scoring team.
They got Marquise Lucas there, a right tackle.
That foul will be assessed on the kickoff.
Josh Lambert on for the extra point. Lambert, a Grosser Award finalist last year, preseason All-American this year. And the extra point is good. After the defense came up with a stop on 4th and 1, the offense marches down the field. Elijah Wellman, a 7-yard touchdown catch. West Virginia on top, 7-0. Welcome back to FS1 College Football presented by Geico. 7-0 West Virginia now on top of Maryland. A good opening scoring drive for them. Wellman, the 7-yard touchdown catch. But seven plays, 51 yards. And Skylar Howard, we were told that he's pretty accurate.
Did a pretty good job there. Remember the penalty now.
Yep.
Maryland's got one of the best kick returners in the country, and Will Likely. And here he's standing on the 10-yard line with a 15-yard head start. This could be a very interesting return.
Nick O'Toole to kick off. Likely. From the 10, he bobbles it. And Likely gets wrapped up at the 16-yard line. Another flag on this play. Well, you're right. It could be interesting.
Yeah, he dropped it. Yeah. He would have had a head start there, Justin. He was right on the 10, but he dropped it.
During the return. Illegal block in the back by the return team. Half the distance from the spot of the foul. First down.
So you compound the mistake right there with that, but let's go back to that touchdown pass.
Well, we talked about the fullback being in the game. That's not something you see a whole bunch from Dana Holgorsen, but Rochelle Schell is going to go with the zone action to the right, and the fullback is going to leak out there to the left. Everybody is moving right. It freezes the linebackers in the end on that side, and not a hard play to make for the Mountaineers.
Ty Johnson in at tailback on first down, takes the handoff. And Johnson able to get some positive yards up to the 13-yard line. Picks up six, second down and four. Jared Barber with the tackle.
Remember how angry this West Virginia team was 2 years ago getting shut out in Baltimore. They had a nice start to this game. Now it's up to Maryland after a fourth down turnover on downs to get something better generated offensively.
Second and four. Quick pass is completed. Out wide to Tavon Jacobs. And another flag on the field.
Chippy game.
You know about those rivalries. And this one's going against Maryland.
This is a Maryland offensive line. Granted, lost their left guard, but not giving up a sack all season long.
Holding. Offense number 85. Half the distance from the spot of the foul. Repeat third down. Correction, repeat second down.
And early in this game, Justin, you see that they're not getting a bad push with their offensive line despite Mike Minter being out.
So penalties hurting Maryland once again. Second and nine. Swing it out, incomplete for Ty Johnson. It was a forward pass.
And that was really set up well. They got the end to bite. Johnson had blockers out in front of him. All he had to do was haul that in. And he had a first down. Unfortunate miscue, and the Terps don't seem to be on the same page offensively right now.
Now facing third and nine. Caleb Rowe, 1 for 6 for just 3 yards here in the early going. Rowe has that one batted down at the line again. The defense stepping up, Noble Wachuku.
Talked about the new defensive look of this Mountaineer football team and a lot of balls. This is the second one, I think, batted down so far. This one, Noble Wachuku, nice bull rush, and he gets that paw up. He doesn't jump too high, stays on the ground in case the quarterback with a pump fake. Great play by Wachuku.
Nicholas Pritchard will punt with K.J. Dillon back at the 45 of Maryland. Not a good punt. Dillon says clear out of the way, takes a Maryland bounce, but West Virginia will start the ball in Maryland territory. A 39-yard punt. West Virginia already up 7-0. Keith Dudzinski and his defense will have a tough task right now. Starting at the 47-yard line of Maryland is West Virginia, already leading 7-0.
Wendell Smallwood in at tailback. On first down, it is the handoff to Smallwood. Look at him break through as he picks up the first down. Up to the 36-yard line, 11-yard run. Sean Davis with the tackle.
Smallwood is not a big guy, but look how he whittles his way, no pun intended, with the wood there, through the mesh, great through the contact zone, and a nice gain on first down.
Stepping up, taking the shot, and there it is, complete to Shento Gibson. Gibson diving. We now welcome those of you who are just watching the race here to the Maryland-West Virginia game. West Virginia leading 7-0 and now on the doorstep of punching it in yet again. Shelton Gibson was marked out at the 4, first and goal from the 4 for the Mountaineers. Justin Kutcher alongside Petros Papadakis, a 32-yard completion from Skylar Howard to Shelton Gibson.
They've shown a lot of good balance offensively to start out this first quarter. Good passing, good running.
Smallwood on the handoff. Smallwood into the end zone. Touchdown, West Virginia. A 4-yard touchdown run for Smallwood, his fourth rushing touchdown of the season.
Watch the fullback who just scored a touchdown, the last touchdown, Wellman, with a big block on Avery Thompson, the linebacker, that really sprung Smallwood into the end zone. Really impressive point of attack blocking by a fullback for a Dana Holgorsen offense. What's going on out here in Morgantown?
It's bizarro world. Josh Lambert on for the extra point. We go. 14-0. West Virginia leading here in this first quarter. The Mountaineers came up with a stop on 4th and 1 on the first series of the game, and then the offense took over. A touchdown pass from Howard to Elijah Wellman, 7 yards out. And then on this last drive, the big play was a 32-yard completion to Shelton Gibson, and then Smallwood, the 4-yard touchdown run. This is what has happened thus far. Both teams with 2 drives.
Maryland looked a lot better offensively starting out the game. Their last drive was a bit of a dud, and they're going to have to find their bearings here in a very tough environment. They're going to play in a lot of tough environments this year. This is really the first one. They've got to find a way to respond here in the first quarter. This sold-out crowd here at Milan Puskás Stadium is bloodthirsty, and these teams don't like each other.
It was critical for this Maryland team to get off to a good start. All of a sudden, if you think about this, if they go 3 and out on this drive, this could be over in a hurry. O'Toole to kick off. William Likely in the end zone. Likely from the goal line. And Likely is tackled at the 19-yard line. Let's take a look at the Terrapins, what's going on so far this year. For Randy Etzel, the Terps, they open the season with a victory over Richmond, 37 unanswered in that second quarter. But then this is where the bad things happened. A loss to Bowling Green, outscored 28-7 in that fourth quarter. And then last week they recovered to beat USF 35-17.
And they think they trail here. Found their quarterback in that game against South Florida. Let's see how Rowe responds here.
Play action. Rowe again going down the field, incomplete. There is a flag on the near side of the field. The intended receiver was Laverne Jacobs, his favorite target. And it's going against Maryland.
Ineligible receiver downfield. Number 8 was covered up and went downfield on a pass. 5-yard penalty, repeat first down.
Well, that's just a matter of alignment for Maryland, and they've had a lot of issues
so far. That's five penalties so far in this game for the Terps. This is an offensive line that's not given up a sack all year, but they've had holding penalties and just a lot of rigmarole to start out.
First and 15. They'll hand off to Brandon Ross. And Ross gets up to the 16-yard line.
Even though you have a talented quarterback who can throw the ball downfield and you want to score a 14-point play right now, if you're the Terps, you've got to remain balanced. That's a problem they've had this year. They have to keep feeding Ross and try to find a way to get their other running back, Wes Brown, involved in the game just to keep their balance. No time to panic for the Terps, but this is a huge set of downs here.
Yeah, they need to stay on the field right now, give the defense a bit of a breather, gain some confidence offensively. Second and 13. Rowe not on the same page with his wide receiver, Amba Etatawa. And now Caleb Rowe is 1 for 8 to open up this game.
Frustration from Rowe. He wanted Etatawa to break that route off, and he continued down the field. Based on the coverage, Rowe was right. But it's hard when you've only had a few starts at quarterback and there's been changes already and it's still September to really know what the other guys are going to do out there for you.
That graphic said a lot, almost as many penalty yards as total yards for the Terrapins. Pressure coming. Rowe trying to escape. He does get rid of it. The pressure applied by Xavier Preston. And another punt coming up. The three and out is forced.
They haven't given up a sack all year. This was almost it. A lot of fire coming from the Mountaineers defense on a third and long. You'd expect Tony Gibson, defensive coordinator, to call something like that. Preston came clean and a good job by Rowe simply just to get rid of it. But here it is again, a punt. Not a lot of rest for that Terps D, and they're coming back out to take on Skylar Howard, who's hot right now.
And K.J. Dillon is standing at midfield with Nicholas Pritchard to punt. Again, a short punt, and this one will be down at the 44 of Maryland. A 28-yard punt for Pritchard. Great field position again for the Mountaineers as they lead 14-0. Just some salt and pepper, put it on the grill, and you'll have a good steak. Keep it simple, 14-0, West Virginia leading Maryland here in the first quarter. How about the Mountaineers? They open the season with a blowout over Georgia Southern, 44-0. And then they played Liberty. It was another easy one for them, 41-17, now leading 14-0. Great field position again, a 44-yard line of Maryland. Russell Shell, Elijah Wellman in the backfield to open up this drive. A handoff to Shell, and he gets back to the line of scrimmage. Quentin Jefferson with the tackle. You saw that graphic. It goes to show you, I mean, here's West Virginia. Their average starting field position, their own 47 in the first three drives. That doesn't bode well for Maryland.
Things could not have started better in this game for the Mountaineers and Dana Holgorsen against their first big-time opponent in a rivalry game.
Second and 10. Howard has that ball batted down at the line. Getting a hand on it was number 37, Avery Thompson. How about our built for tough keys to the game?
Well, first and foremost, Maryland's got to find a way to get ramped up. They got to go to Ohio State. They got to go to Michigan State.
Howard throws, completes the pass. Durant, first down up to the 29, a 15-yard completion.
Durant's a guy with top-off speed, so he had a lot of cushion there in the coverage. Good job coming back to the football, and the Mountaineers are going fast.
Howard throws that one incomplete. Again, not really in sync on that one with Durant. Let's go back to those four keys.
Well, getting ramped up for Maryland means they've got to go to a lot of places like this, and they've got to get used to this environment, and it's not happening right now. And for West Virginia, they've been doing it pretty well. Looks like they're wearing them right now. Put your big boy pants on. This isn't Liberty. I know Georgia Southern's beating some people, but here we go. This is a Big Ten team.
A team out of a Power 5 conference school. Second down and 10. Shell in the backfield. Howard dancing around, throws Shell wide open. He's got the first down, makes one guy miss, keeps those legs churning. And Russell Shell is down at the 13, a 16-yard pickup. Anthony Nixon with a tackle.
Well, this play ended up going to Shell here, and you're going to see him. But he also had Javon Durant on a drive route. You're going to see him coming across the screen clean. That was a touchdown throw as well.
Empty backfield. It's kept by the quarterback, Skylar Howard. Tackled right away by Roman Braglio. Picks up one. I'm going to say he actually lost a couple yards on the play.
And there you see Keith Dudzinski, the defensive coordinator for Maryland, and they're confused right now. There's a lot of holes in this defense and a lot of options for Skylar Howard right now.
Second down and 12, Smallwood now in the backfield. Pass, Gibson. Gibson breaks free, touchdown! Shelton Gibson with his third touchdown of the season has won in each of the first three games, this time a 15-yarder.
By the way, how about that burst of speed?
Yeah, he's fast. They say he's the fastest guy on the team. Compare him a lot to former wide receiver here, Tavon Austin, who's one of the most impressive players I've ever seen, especially in this stadium. He did a good job there setting up his blocks and being patient after making the catch. Nifty move to the end zone.
Josh Lambert on for his third extra point of the quarter. You could not ask for a better start if you're Dana Holgorsen in West Virginia. Three drives, three touchdowns. This time, Shelton Gibson from 15 yards. It's 21-0 Mountaineers. She may get motion sickness if this pace keeps up. 21-0, West Virginia leading Maryland. Both coaches today are wearing a patch of the Coach to Cure MD program to battle muscular dystrophy. Coaches across the country wearing these, trying to raise money. It's already raised over $1 million. Something easy these coaches can do for a great cause. Shelton Gibson, 15-yard touchdown catch. Look at that note right there. 3 for 3 in the red zone today. All of them touchdowns. Nick O'Toole to kick off. William Likely back deep again. Likely will take a knee, and Maryland will start at the 25-yard line. Let's go back at that touchdown play.
Well, this play was really made here with the downfield blocking. You're going to see Sean Davis run around the block of Javon Durant, and that's really what opened up the hole for Gibson to run through. Watch him run around the block. Instead of taking him on there, he runs around the block, and it creates that little space for Gibson to go through and score a touchdown. You got to be more physical out there on the perimeter if you're Maryland.
The last two drives for Maryland, 7 plays, 3 yards, and 2 punts. And both times, West Virginia got the ball in Maryland territory. On first down here, it's Ross. Brandon Ross, a good run, still on his feet, down the sideline, and Ross gets shoved out of bounds by Darryl Worley all the way at the 39-yard line of West Virginia, 36-yard run.
This is not a small back, 5'10", 210-pound, a senior. He knows how to be patient, does a good job of just pushing Henry in front of him and finding the sideline.
Entered this game 15th all-time at Maryland in rushing. Play action. Rowe gets sacked. The first sack of the year given up by the Maryland offensive line. It goes to Shaq Pettaway. A loss of 8.
Shaq Pettaway
coming on a bit of a speed rush on the edge, bringing pressure to Rowe. Young man out of Steubenville High School in Steubenville, Ohio, the hometown of one Dean Martin, one of the greatest singers of all time. He did him proud there with the sack to Pettaway.
Second and long. A handoff to Ross. Ross still moving that pile. Jared Barber, Nick Kwiatkowski combined for the tackle. Third and long coming up here for the Terps.
And you know, Justin, we talked about the little push that this Maryland offensive line has been getting. They have a nice run on first down, but you give up that sack. That was a pretty good gain on second down, but you're still facing third and long because of that negative play. Maryland's got to pull something out of their hat here.
Caleb Rowe not off to a good start. 1 for 9, 3 yards in the air. Wes Brown in that tailback. Rowe down the seam, and that's incomplete. Looking for the true freshman tight end, Avery Edwards.
And that is where Rowe goes wrong. He had the back and the outlet route. Probably could have gotten the first down if he just dumped it off. Instead, he decided not to and go for something a little more. It was not there. Well covered. And that's a tough play. They're going to have to punt it.
Now Brad Craddock is on to punt with K.J. Dillon at his own 10. So a couple of bad punts for Nicholas Pritchard. He's pulled. Craddock gets the punt off. A good one inside the 10, and this will be down around the 7-yard line of West Virginia. Well, West Virginia for so long has been known for their offense, but it's their defense that's really been impressive this year.
They don't look like a finesse team right now. Wachuku with a big play, a lot of physical violence on the perimeter, and they are doing something that other people haven't been able to do to Maryland so far this year, which is get to Caleb Rowe and sack him. The personality of this West Virginia team is changing, and a big part of it is that man, Tony Gibson, the defensive coordinator. His second season was an assistant at Michigan, Pitt, Arizona, before he really came with Rich Rod, and he's one of those 3-3-5 guys, and it's a great fit for the offense they run here.
On first down, Smallwood up the middle. Wendell Smallwood with a big run on first down. He goes all the way to the 29, a 22-yard run. Davis and Hendy combined for the tackle.
Well, when you've had success throwing the ball and getting out to the perimeter, the run lanes become a little bit more vertical when you decide to use them. And that was a really nice crease that Smallwood could get through. I like the way he runs through the contact zone.
And Smallwood again. You know, we thought one of the keys in this game was to get Smallwood in rhythm. And so far with the running game, they're doing it combining with the passing game. It's a balanced attack for West Virginia. Second down and 7. Dana Holgerson calling the shots.
And he's a guy who's got a lot of confidence in his offensive ability. What's interesting is their ability to maintain an identity while doing so many different things.
Hand off again to Smallwood. He busts through. Good cutback. Wendell Smallwood. A flag comes in late as he goes down to 43. William Likely, A.J. Hendy there to finally bring him down. But let's see what this flag is for. A 25-yard run. He had a 22-yard run earlier on this drive. Still waiting for the call from John O'Neill.
Seems complicated.
Personal foul. Face mask. Number 4 on the offense. 15 yards from the end of the run. The line to gain was achieved. First down.
Well, Smallwood with the straight arm, and he gets a full handful of A.J. Hendy's face mask. And as a former running back, I'm going to say that's okay. But it's obviously not. You can't do that. You can't hold it that long. The flag is going to come out. They still get a first down on the play, and still a nice run by Smallwood and a great lead block by the fullback. Not just for the red zone, I guess. Elijah Wellman still out there.
Russell Shell now in at tailback. Play action. Howard forced out of the pocket. And Howard will just throw this one away. A good, smart play by Skylar Howard.
Well, he threw it to Brad Paisley up there in the stand. He really, really got it out there.
Quarterback was outside the pocket. Ball crossed the line of scrimmage.
Speaking of Brad Paisley, we'll talk with him at halftime. Perform Country Roads.
That was good.
That was awesome.
I'm from L.A., and I thought it was good. You know, I'm not much of a country guy, but I was.
See, I live in Charlotte now, so you knew I was excited.
It was emotional for me.
Second down and 10 here for West Virginia, leading 21-0 here in the first quarter. Howard stepping up, throws incomplete. Looked like Jordan Thompson and Shelton Gibson were the two receivers who were in the vicinity of the area. Third and 10 here for West Virginia. Maryland needs a stop. And they will not get it as the flag comes in. Anthony Nixon looked like he made contact. Jordan Thompson, the intended receiver.
That's a tough call.
Pass interference. Pass interference. Defense number 20. The ball will be placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
Anthony Nixon, a senior free safety. A lot of experience. 32 career starts at Maryland. Jordan Thompson, a good wide receiver we talked to yesterday. And maybe with the hand on the hip was the call there. Thompson must have felt it because he pointed at the official. I don't know.
The sixth penalty already. Here's the carry by Shell up the middle. And Shell gets the 44. Jefferson Ashuru brings him down after a pickup of six. Coming up on a minute to go here in this opening quarter. Shell patiently hits the hole, and he has another first down to the 39. It's Sean Davis with his third tackle.
And that's a cornerback making the tackle on a zone run play. The first contact that the back had was the corner, Sean Davis. Not a good sign for this Maryland D. They're getting bludgeoned up on the D-line, and the linebackers are hitting the backs. That time it was a corner.
Zone read again. Pressure coming. This time Howard goes down. Sacked by Jefferson Ashuru. A loss of 13. Big play.
And Ashuru just came pretty clean and made the play. Right now, it looks like, and most offenses are this way, but it wasn't always this way under Dana Holgorsen. West Virginia a lot more comfortable in the second and short with their zone read game, running the ball with their backs. That's the 13th Maryland sack this year. They've been getting after the quarterback pretty well. They need to play better on first and second down against the run.
Smallwood is in there. It is Smallwood. Look at him go. Another good run by Wendell Smallwood, this time a 17-yard run. And that will end this first quarter. 21-0. West Virginia leading Maryland here in this rivalry game. FS1 College Football, presented by GEICO, will return after these messages.
It's a van, but anybody who plays disciplined levels on defense, and we've seen USC do it, Stanford do it, Arizona do it last year, might have a chance at Autzen Stadium.
21-0 here at Milan Puskar Stadium on the Gold Rush, 60,000 strong, a sellout. The Mountaineers have owned the first half this year in three games. It is third and 7, Wendell Smallwood in at tailback. Smallwood 85 yards on the ground in that first quarter. They give it to him again, and why not? And this time Smallwood gets wrapped up. A good tackle by Jarrett Ross, number 32.
And that's some physicality, a little bit of pushback.
from Ross and this Maryland defense. They were getting a real tongue lashing from Randy Edsall on the sideline during the break and responded pretty well, forcing a fourth down kick here.
Josh Lambert to try a 51-yard field goal attempt. One of the best kickers in the country. From 51, it is no good. Could not draw it in. A missed field goal for Lambert. Something positive for Maryland. What can they do on offense when they come back? Huddle up with college football experts and live web chats all season long. A new guest every week, the Edward Jones College Football Huddle on FoxSports.com. Second quarter here in Morgantown. Maryland trailing 21-0. Brandon Ross, Kenneth Goins Jr. in the backfield here for the Terps. Caleb Rowe, a first quarter to forget the handoff to Ross. And Ross up to the 39, picks up five, tackled by Kyle Rose.
Needless to say, down 21 with a great start by the Mountaineers. Huge drive for the Terps and a nice first down gain by Ross.
They give it right back, and this time he gets hit in the backfield. Nick Kwiatkowski, the guy who led this team in tackles through the first two games, led them last year in tackles with 103, has two in this one.
Bethel Park, Pennsylvania, kind of the heartbeat of this D. The second that Brandon Ross turned his back to the line of scrimmage trying to make a move, Kwiatkowski hammered him right in the small of the back. That's a physical linebacker.
Third and five. Wes Brown in on third down again. Rose pass is complete on the slant for the first down. Able to bring that one in was Laverne Jacobs. A big third down conversion for the Terps.
Well, he had Laverne Jacobs in the slot, and when you haven't had much success offensively in a first quarter like that, you got to get back to basics. Run the zone, and then throw a slant. Nice first down. We'll see if it calms Caleb Rowe down a little.
Just the second completion of the game for Rowe. The handoff to Ross up the middle. And Ross gets up to the 47. Shaq Bedaway there for the stop. A five-yard pickup for Brandon Ross. Second down and five here for Maryland. And this is important when you get those five-yard gains on first down.
Makes the playbook a lot bigger for second down, especially with a quarterback who hasn't played a whole bunch, didn't start the year as the starter. Bodes well for him.
They dump it out to Johnson, too far out in front. The pressure was coming yet again from West Virginia.
Now, if that's a throw to a wide receiver, he can go make that play. But if you're throwing it to a running back on that kind, unless it's Marshall Faulk or something, it's got to be right on his chest, 1 foot in front of the numbers. That's on Caleb Rowe.
Wes Brown in on third and five. They just converted moments ago. 3 for 7 on third down so far today. Rowe taking a shot down the field, incomplete, was looking for Jacobs. Caleb Rowe is now 2 for 13 for 13 yards.
And we were told in the meeting yesterday that if that quarterback drops back 7 steps and throws it down the field, he's going to get hit. And he's been taking licks all afternoon from this West Virginia D.
Brad Craddock on to punt yet again. K.J. Dillon lets it bounce into the end zone. Good job by Dillon. It'll be West Virginia ball when we come back. You think Smallwood might get it? He's already got 87 yards on the ground today. Nothing. West Virginia leading Maryland. Wendell Smallwood, 8 carries, 87 yards thus far for the Mountaineers.
He's been hard to bring down and really good through the contact zone. Pretty big back, 5'11", 202 pounds, and getting his upper body involved when people come to tackle him. Really physical at the finish of the runs, and he's had a great, great head start from his fullback, Elijah Wellman, who's really my MVP of this first half. He's hitting guys out there on the Maryland team. Who would know that West Virginia's team, not just a great rushing team so far in this game, but great with the fullback and physical with two backs in the backfield. You don't see that a lot from Dana Holgorsen's team.
Smallwood and Shell. A handoff to Shell. Shell bounces out one would-be tackler. Picks up a first down. A 14-yard run. A.J. Hendy finally bringing them down.
And we were told we were going to see both tailbacks in the backfield at the same time. That was Shell and Smallwood. Usually it's just one of those guys taking the carry.
Now Shell splits out. In the pocket, throwing over the middle, completes the pass. Bouncing off one defender again is Shorts, and he's got a first down up to the 49 of Maryland.
And now that's seven completions for Skylar Howard to five different receivers. They're doing a good job of distributing the ball to a lot of their playmakers.
Skylar Howard whips it out quickly. Devontae Mathis. This offense right now is clicking here on this drive. A 7-yard pickup for West Virginia. Second down and three.
And the reason West Virginia got the ball back was just a little miscue by Caleb Rowe. Just a little off on the throw to his tailback. And you see how important the details are in football. Now the Mountaineers have the ball back and they're threatening the Terps again.
Smallwood. Smallwood this time got wrapped up by the ankles by Sean Davis with his fifth tackle.
Pretty impressed with Sean Davis. He's a boundary cornerback, but not a small guy. 6'1", 202 pounds. And that's about the second tackle he's had on a tailback right around the line of scrimmage.
Now third and two. Mathis in motion. Howard changing the play. On third and two. Howard taking a shot towards the end zone. Touchdown! Shelton Gibson, 41 yards. We were told Skylar Howard can throw it. What a beautiful pass this was.
And this is up against one of the best corners in the Big Ten, Will Likely. Howard really led him, put the ball out there, not afraid of the speed. Ah, the cheerleader goes down, too. Terrible.
Hopefully the cheerleader's okay.
I hope so.
Josh Lambert on for the extra point.
Almost led him right out of the back of the end zone. A lot of faith in his speed, and he showed it.
Lambert's extra point is good. Shelton Gibson, three catches, 88 yards, two touchdowns on the day. Skylar Howard puts it on the spot. You see a Blue Jay in the picture there, Josh Donaldson. Probably the American League MVP. The Blue Jays back in the postseason.
No love for Mike Trout, Justin?
Not yet.
No love?
No.
I mean, we're talking about one of the great players of all time.
I know.
I don't think that award goes across the border to Canada, Justin.
Nick O'Toole will kick off. William Likely back deep again. Likely a chance to return here at the 10. Likely's explosive. But good coverage on special teams by West Virginia. Well, now it's time for Lowe's game break. Let's go back to L.A. and check in with Jenny Taft.
Thanks, Justin. Number five Baylor hosting Rice. Seth Russell finds Corey Coleman for the 35-yard score. That's Russell's fourth touchdown pass today, giving him 13 already this season. The Bears lead the Owls 35-10 in the second quarter. Justin Petros, back to you guys.
Well, here in Morgantown, it has been all Mountaineers thus far. 10:31 to go here in the second quarter. Maryland with Ross and Goins in the backfield on first down. Play action. Rowe stepping up wide open is his receiver, and he misses Laverne Jacobs.
And when you have a quarterback that likes to throw the ball down the field. He's going to drop back far so his receivers can get down the field. It's pretty simple geometry. That means you're going to have more time to get to him. And he's been getting hit almost on every play. That time it was Nick Kwiatkowski. They're coming from all over the place. This 3-3-5, very difficult to pinpoint where the blitzers are coming from. They're constantly moving the dots on the quarterback. And Rose having trouble with it. He had Jacobs wide open.
2 for 14 on the day. Now make it 3 for 15 as he completes the pass to Edetawa. A 5-yard completion sets up 3rd and 5. Ty Johnson stays in at tailback here on 3rd down. Usually we see Wes Brown in this position. Rowe throws low, and a punt coming up for Maryland. Jared Barber once again applying the pressure. And if you're Maryland on the sideline, if you're a fan watching at home, you're thinking something's got to happen. 3 for 16 for 18 yards for Caleb Rowe today. The 5th punt of this first half, and now Nicholas Pritchard is back in to punt. Pritchard had a couple of poor punts early. Now punting with the wind, gets a good one. Dillon at the 25. KJ Dillon gets run out as he crosses the 35 at the 36-yard line. 28-0. The Mountaineers leading this in the border war. Go. Here a gold rush at Milan Puskar Stadium in Morgantown, West Virginia. And I guess the Mountaineers like playing in front of all this gold. They lead 28-0. Shelton Gibson this season, look at that. 6 catches of at least 20 yards. 2 of them in today's game. He's also got a couple of touchdowns. On 1st down, the handoff to Smallwood. Smallwood's done a good job hitting the hole here today and getting those positive yards.
And he's doing it with a lead guy. Elijah Wellman came across the formation there and led through beautifully. This 2-back system working well.
This time he gets wrapped up as he hits the line. Brett Kolka with the tackle, setting up 3rd down. And a couple yards to go. Gibson and Smallwood, the leaders, one receiving, one rushing. Elijah Wellman, the tailback. The throw on 3rd down is incomplete, looking for Smallwood. And Smallwood with the ball behind him, he got hit in the back. That could not feel good.
Yeah, they were trying a little Texas route for the running back. And usually that Mike Backer, or whoever's got the middle of the field responsibility there, clears out. There's the ball. And kind of an ill-advised throw with 2 guys in the vicinity from Skylar Howard. And not a bad stand by this Maryland defense, you know, trying to get something positive going to get their offense involved.
The first punt of the day, the first return for Lightly, but we will not get a chance to return it. This one goes into the end zone for a touchback. Coming up, it's a State Farm FS1 College Football Halftime Show with Rob Stone, Dave Wonstadt, and Matt Leinart in Los Angeles. LSU's on the road at Syracuse. How about Michigan against BYU at home, just annihilating them? And, of course, we've got a special interview with 3-time Grammy Award winner Brad Paisley, who sang Country Roads prior to the game in front of the sold-out crowd.
I mean, I don't know if it would have been better if it was John Denver. It was really good.
Caleb Rowe on 1st down. He finds Laverne Jacobs, and Jacobs is going to be taken down for a loss by K.J. Dillon, a loss of 5.
And these are tough calls. The last 2 first downs to start drives, Maryland has opted to throw the ball, even though they're getting a pretty good push with Brandon Ross running it. And here they are, 2nd down, way behind the chains.
Rowe taking the shot down the field, and this one, it is picked off. Terrell Chestnut. They said if he threw it up, they were going to be there.
Chestnut was there. This is a guy who's battled through a lot of injuries at West Virginia, a shoulder and an ACL. Takes a nice bail approach. He's got great position and makes that pick. I'm not sure why the ball was ever really thrown. Nobody was open. That was Malcolm Colmer out there. Didn't really expect to see the ball coming. Rowe must have saw something that he didn't see right after the snap. And that ball is picked off and everything going wrong for this Maryland offense, in particular, the junior quarterback, Caleb Rowe.
He's on the phone right now saying what he saw. Skylar Howard back on the field, dumps one off. Shelton Gibson, room to run. And Shelton Gibson down to the 32-yard line. A.J. Handy with a seventh tackle, a 16-yard pickup.
You know, we talked about this team finding an offensive identity against a good opponent, West Virginia. And so far, that offensive identity, Justin, has been balanced. Mm-hmm. They've been able to do everything.
It's kicked by Howard on the beautiful zone read. This is what we talked about in the open, a different style quarterback for West Virginia, and Skylar Howard did that perfectly.
And they have not needed his legs so far. That's a nice little mesh with the back, and he finds his way, protects the ball at the end of the run.
Now second and one, swinging out wide, Durant. And Durant gets stopped by William Likely.
Now, Will Likely
is the first down.
He struggled in this game. The great cornerback, William Likely, 5'7", 175-pound junior out of Belle Glades, Florida. This is an all-Big Ten performer, and he's a great returner. He's already dropped one of those. He got burned on a touchdown by Gibson.
Empty backfield. Howard up the middle. Skylar Howard inside the 10, down to the 8. Another first down, a 13-yard run for him. The first time we're seeing him use his legs.
You might see more of this with the Big 12 starts. This was a called quarterback draw because the center you see is headhunting after a couple seconds of a pass set. Really nice call and a good feel by Dana Holgerson. And here's the fullback back in the game.
Shell with Elijah Wellman, the fullback. Shell maybe gets a yard. Jalen Brooks was right there.
Number 43, Jalen Brooks has got for Maryland.
6:40 to go here in this first half. 28-0. West Virginia trying to add to its lead. William Likely, the great return man, a good corner as well. But having himself a game he'd like to maybe forget. Look at this discrepancy in total yards. Second and goal from the 7. It's number 7, Shell. And Shell takes it down to the 2. It's Jalen Brooks again with a stop, combining with A.J. Hendy.
How about this bully-like approach from the Mountaineers in the red zone? Fullback, tailback. It's like Stanford's playing here. There's no secret about where they're going to go. And right now, Maryland just absorbing these punches at the chest, getting pushed back.
And again, you have the fullback in. Elijah Wellman with Shell. Third and goal from the 2. Shell. Second effort. Shell, touchdown.
He's going to get rejected by the 3 technique, Quinton Jefferson, right at the point of attack in the A gap, and a great job by Jefferson, you know, trying to wrap him up, but he's got an old lineman hanging on him. That's all Shell. He was able to take a step back and bounce it out to the side and find the end zone. Sometimes you need a running back to erase lack of push in the goal line situations, and Shell was able to do it there. And West Virginia's got it going on, Justin.
His second rushing touchdown of the season, a 2-yard run. Josh Lambert on to make it 35-0. Dana Holgerson said the loss in 2013 was the worst of his career, 37-0. His team leads 35-0 in the second quarter. Will Likely from the five. And Likely gets out to the 25-yard line. And that's where Maryland will start, trailing by 35. And you almost wonder, trailing 35-0, 4 for 18 for 13 yards and one interception, will we maybe see a quarterback change for Maryland at some point?
It's certainly a fair question right now. You got Perry Hills, who started the season. He's not listed as their second quarterback. Right now, the second quarterback is number 18. You see there with the red hat on, Dax Garmon. If you recognize that name, he played at Oklahoma State. He's a graduate transfer from there. He's one of Gundy's guys for a while.
On first down, the pass is complete to Avery Edwards, the true freshman tight end. A first down as they pick up 10 on first.
You know, the question right now at this point in the second quarter, where this game is really seemingly gotten away from Maryland, is where's the balance offensively, and how simple do you have to make things, and how good is this West Virginia D really?
Ross up the middle. Up to the 40, gets four, second down and six. But you also have to wonder, with 5 minutes to go here in the first half, down by 35, you know, people will say, well, you got to throw the ball because you got to score quickly. But I almost wonder if, hey, let's just see if Maryland can get something going offensively, keep a balanced attack, and prepare for that Big Ten season.
First downs.
On second and six, it's Ross again.
And this is going to set up another third and short, to your point, Justin. It's just important at this point for Maryland, the score being what it is. And I'm not saying the game's over. I mean, we've seen the Buffalo Bills come back from this against the Houston Oilers in the NFL playoffs when I was a child. But you just got to find a way to get your confidence and to find a way to get first downs and then go from there. You have to kind of strip it down and start from square one when the game starts like this for your football team.
Third and two. Ross able to get outside through the hole. Ross down the sideline. It's a foot race. Ross tripped up. Ball comes out. And they're going to say he was down. The ball was down. His knee was down. And he is down at the one. 55-yard run for Brandon Ross, chased down by Jarrell Chestnut.
I love the way Brandon Ross continued to bubble this outside. Here's the end of the play. Knee down. Oof.
1.5-yard line.
Pretty close there.
They just showed the replay here.
That ball looks out, Justin, and that is a terrible break.
Before the ball came out.
The ruling on the field, remember, is that the runner was down, so it's going to have to be conclusive evidence. And right before that knee went down, it did look like the ball came out as he tried to stretch it.
And went through the end zone.
Touchback. That's going to be West Virginia ball if they do end up reversing the call. It was a great run by Ross. Up until this point, the right knee is what you're going to want to see, and it's down, but the ball is out before that. And at this point, if you're a Maryland person, you say, bad luck today in Morgantown. But a really nice run by Ross. It's really hard to take that away from him. He did a great job kind of bubbling and finding the green grass and then using what speed he had. But he got run down, and a great job by Chestnut not giving up on the play. You don't give up on plays like that, and sometimes good things happen for you on defense.
And Chestnut was the guy who had the interception on that last possession. The ball's coming loose right there.
Well, stranger things have happened. We disagreed a little earlier in the game on the helmet-to-helmet contact, and they ended up not calling targeting on that one after a replay. Let's see the direction this one goes in. But my guess, which
I think you and I disagreed on that one as well.
We did. You and I did, yeah. That's what I meant when we said we, but I think this one's going to go against the Terps.
The runner lost possession of the ball before he was down. The ball was fumbled forward through the end zone. The result of the play is a touchback.
From bad to worse for Maryland. Just when things are looking good, a 55-yard run by Brandon Ross. He fumbles at around the 1 yard line. And the Maryland fans who made the trip here, yeah, those faces, they say it all.
But it's a great atmosphere. We can be happy about that. It's a wonderful place here in Morgantown, but those 7 points would have gone a long way for the Terps' confidence going into the locker room, and now they have to face Howard.
On first down, it's Shell. Russell Shell gets three. Second down and seven coming up. Empty backfield here for Skylar Howard. Both running backs are in. Shell and Smallwood split out wide. Howard with time dumps it off to Smallwood. And Smallwood has the first down up to the 36-yard line.
Interesting play call there by Dana Holgerson. Empty backfield. Everybody pushes their way down the field except for Smallwood, who comes across the formation on a drag route. Wide open, pretty easy throw for Skylar Howard. They really have their entire offense working in the right direction in Morgantown today.
Wendell Smallwood, now the tailback. Howard, towards the sideline, incomplete. Javon Durant tried to make the adjustment. A flag is thrown. Sean Davis there on the coverage.
That's interference. Defense number 21. 15 yards from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
They got Sean Davis, the physical corner, out there. Number 21, you're going to see him in his coverage. Good position, but then he has to turn his hips around. Durant did a good job getting his body around in a position to make the play. Pretty emotional coach on the sideline, Dana Holgerson. He's always fun to watch.
Seventh penalty, 65 yards for Maryland. Howard across the middle completes this pass to Jordan Thompson. 17-yard pickup. West Virginia going a little bit of a hurry up.
Really good throw. That's a good throw. That's the most impressive throw I've seen from Skylar Howard, other than the long touchdown to Gibson early in the game. And he really threaded the needle there to Thompson. Thompson made the catch and then protected himself.
First and 10 from the 32. Smallwood gets stood up at the 29. 3 yard pickup. Anthony Nix in there with his third tackle of the first half. The pass deflected, picked off. Nixon. Anthony Nixon gets run out at the 29-yard line. The first turnover of the game for West Virginia as that ball was deflected in the air.
With Sean Davis, the corner there on Durant, they've been battling all day. Just got a pass interference call against him against the same receiver. That ball behind Durant enabled Davis to get a hand on it and popped it up. A little tip drill action for Anthony Nixon, who did a good job catching it at its highest point, protecting the ball, and some positivity for Maryland. Not giving up points.
So the first turnover for the Mountaineers. Delayed handoff. Ty Johnson. And Johnson doesn't have much. Coming up, it's a State Farm FS1 College Football Halftime Show. Michigan State, number 2 in the land, looking to stay unbeaten. They beat Oregon. Oregon, of course, on Fox tonight against Utah. Play action. That is a picked off. It is K.J. Dillon. Picked off at the 39.
Dillon out of Apopka, Florida, the senior, doing a great job.
But they're not even looking for the ball. Nobody got their head around on this play to find that ball. Dillon was the only one really going after it.
The question is, does he have control?
Davenport, the wide receiver who was never really looking for that ball in the first place. Looks like we're going to play.
First down from the 40 for West Virginia. Shell. Shell. Down to the 37-yard line.
Justin, this is one of the hardest things for a defense. You know, you get a turnover, you come to the sideline, you just sit down and take off your helmet, and all of a sudden, your offense gives it right back, and you got to come back on the field, and here comes this very balanced West Virginia offense. Looked like Shell got a little banged up on that play.
It looked like he was cramping a little bit now as Wendell Smallwood comes in. The zone read, the handoff to Smallwood. And Wendell Smallwood, with that carry of 7 yards, is up over 100 here for the first half. Jalen Brooks with his sixth tackle. Second down and three. 106 yards here in the first half for Wendell Smallwood. Smallwood again. Still on his feet. Down to the 21, A.J. Hendy with a stop, a pickup of 9, second and 1.
And he's saying he's not tired. Wendell Smallwood, a player we got to meet with yesterday, a great smile and a lot of confidence. And I like what this West Virginia offense is doing. Obviously, they're playing very well in this game. But they're not putting everything on Skylar Howard. It's been the fullback, the tailback. They've got a lot of guys involved.
Howard, pressure coming. Howard runs out of bounds. Got a nice block as his receiver, Dakeel Shorts, came back to block for him. Stops the clock with 19 seconds.
Listen to this.
Oof. There is a flag down on the field.
Well, they might be calling him a defenseless player. Jermaine Carter, the one that got hit by Shorts.
Don't forget, coming up at halftime, our exclusive interview with Brad Paisley, a 3-time Grammy Award country music superstar. We'll talk with him at half.
I wish you would have brought your country hat for that, Justin.
Personal foul, offense number 6. 15 yards from the end of the run. Repeat first down.
So much for that nice block by Dakeel Shorts.
They don't like you cracking back on guys like they used to. When you get a guy like that, they're going to call it. It's about protecting players and the new college football, and he lowered his shoulder and hit him around the jaw. In my day, that's a great block. It's 15 yards.
I think in today it's still a great block. I mean, it wasn't like he was defenseless. Backs it up now to the 34. Dump it off. Down the sideline. Dante Thomas Williams made the play, but there is a flag down in the backfield. It's coming back. Marquise Lucas
took down Yannick Ngakoue, the end. It looked like those two guys were going at it on the turf.
Holding. Offense number 78. 10 yards from the previous spot. Repeat first down.
And that is Ngakoue against Lucas. And that's a hold. And then he stayed on top of him after the flag came down to get his money's worth. You're going to get the penalty. You might as well get your money's worth.
I agree.
Holgorsen upset about the block like you were, Justin, and now upset about that hold call.
Charge timeout.
So a timeout's called now by West Virginia. With 8 seconds to go in the half, which gives us a chance to go to Jenny Taft for a game break.
Justin, thanks. Number one, Ohio State hosting Western Michigan. And after being benched last weekend, Cardale Jones gets the start and does this as he finds Jalen Marshall for the 37-yard score. Western Michigan has since answered, but the Buckeyes still lead 14-6 in the second quarter. Justin, back to you.
All right, so last week, Ohio State had a tough time with Northern Illinois. Now they are leading Western Michigan, but here it's all West Virginia, 35-0. The game clock is reset to 9 seconds. Justin Kutcher alongside Petros Papadakis here in Morgantown, West Virginia. The Mountaineers, they talked about this rivalry and how much this game means to them. And they have come out, and I tell you what, they have really made a statement here in this first half.
And it really looks to me like this team, and it's really a feel thing, but it does look like they're out there playing for each other. And that was one of their messages when we met with Dana Holgorsen and his staff and some players yesterday. And it's come to fruition here on the field in the first half.
412 yards of offense for West Virginia in the first half. The pass is completed to Jordan Thompson. And they call a timeout here with 2 seconds to get into field goal range. Josh Lambert missed from 51 earlier. Fox Sports Supports has brought the team with Boys and Girls Clubs of America, supporting their mission in helping young people to reach their full potential through programs that promote character and leadership, education, healthy lifestyles, and more. For more information, visit foxsportssupports.com. A 48-yard field goal attempt for Josh Lambert to close out this first half.
These are the two best kickers in the nation. These guys have groza dreams. Some have been fulfilled already.
Lambert from 48. He missed from 51. He splits the uprights from 48. And that will do it here for the first half. All Mountaineers. It is halftime here in Morgantown with a score 38-0. West Virginia coming up after the short break. We'll get you to L.A. for our State Farm halftime show. West Virginia 38-0 as we get set to start the third quarter over Maryland. Justin Kutcher alongside Petros Papadakis back here in the booth. And Petros, it was as good of a start as Dana Holgorsen could have hoped for, and they carried that momentum all the way through that first half.
Especially in a rivalry game, West Virginia humiliating their opponent on their home field. And they've been doing it by running the ball. You want to take the football out of your opponent? Run the ball. Wendell Smallwood doing a great job of just penetrating this defense over and over again, and some great help from his fullback, who's kind of been the MVP of this game so far for me, Elijah Wellman, who's had some big hits and a touchdown of his own.
On the other side, it's Caleb Rowe, and it's not been a good first half for him, dealing with some pressure from the West Virginia defense, and he can't find anything.
Having a tough time. And he's a drop back, throw it down the field style quarterback. Well, the problem is you got to be clean if you're dropping back 7 steps to throw the ball down the field. And he's getting hit over and over again. They've had some success running the ball, but not enough to generate any points. An unfortunate fumble by Ross in the third quarter. Rowe's been very frustrated, and you wonder what the future of this quarterback situation is at Maryland, because Rowe was not the starter to start the season.
Yeah, you saw those numbers that he put up in that first half. They were not pretty. Dax Garmon has his helmet on, the transfer from Oklahoma State. Wouldn't be surprised to see him in this game. Caleb Rowe, number 7. Dax Garmon, number 18. A look at the stats from the first half, and if you're a Maryland fan, look away.
It's been pretty lopsided, although you see the 151 rushing yards right here. Not bad at all for Maryland. They've been able to get some push. A lot of that came on a Brandon Ross would-be touchdown runner, at least inside the 5, that he ended up fumbling.
passing yards, very lopsided, and they've done a great job, the Mountaineers have, at Dana Holgorsen, of calling plays and getting Skylar Howard involved in this game, but not putting the whole game on him. They've done a good job of finding a way to get their new quarterback acclimated to this big conference-style play.
Brad Craddock will kick off. Shelton Gibson, K.J. Dillon back deep. The first time we're seeing Craddock kick off in this game. Third quarter underway. Dillon, he's going to return this from about 8 yards deep in the end zone. Dillon hurdles a defender, fumbles, still loose. And we'll have to wait to see who recovered. Maryland has it.
Well, K.J. Dillon, first of all, making the decision to take this out of the end zone, showing a lot of athleticism, and it's Will Likely, it looks like, forced that fumble. The great cornerback playing on the kickoff team pulled that ball away from Dillon. The safety, or spur player, is what they call him on the West Virginia defense, also returns it. In retrospect, you say, shouldn't have taken it out, but it was a good return up until the moment he lost the ball.
Shane Cockrell was the player who recovered it on special teams for Maryland, so the best starting field position of the day for the Terps at the 27 of West Virginia. It is Caleb Rowe coming back near side. The jump ball intercepted. Carl Joseph. And I'm going to go on a limb and say that might be the last pass of the day for Caleb Rowe.
Well, he got hit again. Another long drop back. Shaq Pettaway, the senior linebacker, put a big hit on him, and that ball floated for a long time. Carl Joseph just out-jumped the receiver for the ball. That's a long developing play with a half roll and then throw it back to the pylon. Maryland trying to take advantage of the field position and the turnover. That's Wes Brown out there, the running back.
Fourth interception of the season for Joseph. On first down here, they swing it out to Wendell Smallwood, and a flag comes in, and the wheels are coming off for the Terps. Sean Davis this time. He'll get called for a personal foul.
After the play was over, personal foul, late hit out of bounds. Defense, number 21, 15 yards from the end of the run. Automatic first down.
Sean Davis is coming up. Might make the argument that he was blocked into him, but that argument would fall on deaf ears as he chipped him with his shoulder and extended the arms. Easy call.
By the way, three of the last four possessions from Maryland have resulted in interceptions for Caleb Rowe. Russell Schell. He'll get a yard on first down.
You know, another mind-boggling stat from the first half is that Maryland had four possessions that were three plays or less. You know, that possession, one play. And it's just not a chemistry experiment for winning football, especially when you're on the road in an environment like this.
On second and nine, Howard out of the pocket, throws to Schell. Schell's got some blockers. Russell Schell looks like he may have fumbled it. Able to recover it. And he is at the 37-yard line of Maryland.
Schell had some issues with cramping in the first half. Back out there in the second, he's done a good job of complimenting Wendell Smallwood so far in this game. But if you're Dana Holgorsen, you want these guys to clean it up a little bit. You use this second half, even if Maryland's not very competitive, to work on the fundamentals and especially for your running backs, ball security.
Smallwood splits out. Howard escapes the pressure. And he will just run out of bounds. Might lose a yard.
You know, I half expected him with all the talk we've heard about him and how much of a chip he has on his shoulder. I half expected Howard to duck his shoulder and try to get a yard, but a much smarter play by Dana Holgorsen's quarterback there. And he's a ball player, quote unquote, from Dana Holgorsen. I mean, here's a guy that really understands what his role is on this team, and he's playing it well.
Hand off. Smallwood. Flags are flying. Helmets are coming off. What's next? Our pets' heads are falling off.
Pretty bird.
Personal foul. Hands to the face. Defense number 99. 15 yards. Automatic first down.
That's Quentin Jefferson.
Number 62 does not have to leave the game.
95 yards of penalties.
As a result of a foul.
It's also a heck of a headlock.
Usually when a defensive lineman like Quentin Jefferson, 6'3", 289, gets his hands on you if you're a running back, play's probably over.
First and 10 from the 21. Smallwood able to hop forward to the 19, gets two, second down and eight. You also wonder, the starters for West Virginia maybe get a couple of more series. And do you rest them? Because they've already had their bye week, and their schedule coming up in Big 12 play is brutal. Durant in motion. Skylar Howard can't escape the pressure by Yannick Ngakoue. And he gets sacked, a loss of nine.
Ngakoue, a third down specialist out of Bowie, Maryland, takes an inside route and reroutes the tight end a little bit, who Howard was trying to find on that play, Cody Clay, and does a great job of not buying any fakes.
Third and 16. Howard throws behind his running back, Wendell Smallwood. And that brings up fourth down, and that'll bring out the kicker, Josh Lambert, who connected from 48 before the half.
And I think it was nice for Lambert, after missing a longer one earlier in the half, in the first half, to get another shot to see it go through the uprights here, as West Virginia just has an opportunity now just to work a lot of their stuff, try to get people involved and keep these positive feelings going.
A 44-yard field goal attempt here for Lambert, missed from 51, connected from 48. And it looked like maybe somebody got a piece of it. It just was low, and he misses this one. So he's 1-for-3 on the afternoon, and it stays 38-0 West Virginia here in Morgantown.
Changed the trajectory of the kick. Nice play by Quentin Jefferson, one of the few positives for Maryland today.
Caleb Rowe is still in there at quarterback, now running the option. The pitch to Ross. And Ross gets stood up. A loss of a yard. Nick Kwiatkowski was right there.
Kwiatkowski with a great job of scraping over. They did a good job of forcing the pitch. Not that Caleb Rowe really wanted to fake it and take it up the field himself. And standing up Ross, who's a pretty tough back. And unfortunately, he had the fumble near the goal line. Brandon Ross been a pretty good performer for Maryland today.
Second and 11. Rowe over the middle. That one is brought down by Avery Edwards. And a first down up by midfield.
Well, this is how Maryland wants their offense to look. Quarterback standing back there clean and delivering strikes to receivers, making plays in front of DBs.
A 24-yard completion on that one. Ross up the middle, gets 3 yards. Noble Wachuku with the stop, second down and 7. That 24-yard completion by Rowe matched his total yards coming into this play. He had 24 yards on the day on 5 completions, and he had 24 yards on that one. Rowe with some time over the middle again. And this time it's Tavon Jacobs able to bring it in.
Tavon Jacobs and his brother Laverne Jacobs, two of the brighter wide receivers and brothers starting at wide receiver for this Maryland offense. Both of them pretty big play guys. Laverne is the bigger, Tavon only 5'9", Laverne's 5'11", and this is how this Maryland offense wants to play.
Les Brown now in at tailback. The option pitch to Brown. And Brown, he does lower that shoulder against Darryl Worley. And Worley's a guy who, I'll say this, because he said it to us, he hates Maryland.
Yeah, he had a big problem with the way that Maryland handled themselves in the Baltimore game 2 years ago when they were blown out and shut out. Looked a lot like this score right now. Worley came up and delivered a pretty good hit. Good hit from both guys. Brown, too.
Flags are thrown. Rowe went down.
A lot of laundry on the field today.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense number 36. Half the distance from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
That's Shaq Pettaway.
He's been no stranger to hitting Caleb Rowe in this game. He's been in the backfield a whole bunch. This time he should have held off.
Yeah, easy call right there for the officials. So now it's a first down at the 13-yard line. First red zone opportunity for the Terps on the day. Remember that fumble at the 1 yard line. Screen pass to Brown. And he's going to get dropped for a loss of a yard. Jared Barber with his fifth tackle.
Nice to have Jared Barber back for West Virginia. 2014 redshirted with an ACL and a little bit of an infection. So he's been around a long time, and he wasn't able to go against Liberty or Georgia Southern. They said he was okay against Liberty, but they gave him because they had the bye week. He's so old on this team, teammates call him Coach. Redshirt senior.
I guess that's better than Grandpa.
Yeah, or Uncle Jared.
Play action. Rowe. Oh, great open field tackle and hit by Terrell Chestnut on Avery Edwards.
Remember, Chestnut is the guy with the great effort play to run down Brandon Ross and pretty much force that fumble when Maryland was threatening. And this time comes up and shows that he's a physical. Both these corners, Darryl Worley and Terrell Chestnut. That's a textbook tackle. You want to show somebody how to tackle, that's a great way to do it. Tackle big, use your fingers, drive your feet behind you. Almost forced a fumble.
He's had himself a nice game. That tackle for a loss of 2 yards. The interception, that play that you mentioned to chase down Brandon Ross to prevent a touchdown, then force the fumble. There is a player down on the field. The injured player is Christian Brown. Well, the wait is finally over. Two legendary heavyweights meet for the first time as Josh Barnett takes on Roy Nelson in a long-awaited matchup. Plus, it's the biggest challenge yet for Uriah Hall as he takes on Gegard Mousasi. UFC Fight Night is tonight at 10 p.m. Eastern only on FS1.
Those guys look mean, Justin.
I think you should grow a beard.
I unfortunately, as a Greek, I am not as hairy as a lot of the Greeks you see out there.
Third and 13. Rowe in the pocket, throws and completes the pass. It's tight end Derek Hayward, but fourth down coming up.
With Rowe still in this game, it gives you a good idea of what Randy Edsall is thinking. And what he's thinking is, this is our quarterback. We like his arm. We like his ability to throw. We're going to have to find a way to get him more comfortable in this game. And they're going to try to get something on fourth down here with him.
It was the opening series of the game when they went for it on fourth and one and got stuck. Now fourth and seven, trailing by 38. Rowe with time. That one is picked off.
Coach Edsall might want to rethink that decision and go with the three. Great play by Worley, though.
Another interception for West Virginia. The lead stays at 38. Randy Edsall, after that last interception, the fourth interception thrown by Caleb Rowe, turned to Dax Garmon, said, get ready. And he is getting ready. Looks like he'll be coming in the next series for the Terps.
Yeah, he had seen enough at that point. Four interceptions for Caleb Rowe.
Skylar Howard has both his tailbacks, Shell and Smallwood, in the backfield with him. On first down, he gets hit. And he was able to get rid of it. Incomplete, the pressure. Quentin Jefferson.
Quentin Jefferson, we said it earlier, has been a bright spot. He blocked the kick. He's done some good things, getting penetration of the defensive line, and that's a big man out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, not far from here, making his 20th start here at Maryland. 3.5 sacks in 3 games last year. So lighten it up a little bit in a lopsided game.
Second down and 10. Smallwood goes in motion. The handoff to Shell. And Shell diving forward gets 4th. Third down and 6. Jalen Rose and Roman Braglio combine for the tackle. They're going hurry up. Howard out of the pocket. Throws towards the sideline. A good grab with the hands by Shelton Gibson. A strong throw by Howard as well.
And this is something that Dana Holgorsen's going to want to see out of his quarterback. He is a mobile guy. And sometimes when you have a mobile quarterback and they decide to start moving to the pocket, they'll tuck that ball and run. He was moving in the pocket, but he kept his eyes down the field and delivered the ball. And the officials are conferencing again.
A substitution on the defense. 12 players on the field. That penalty will be declined. The result of the play is a first down.
Well, still got a first down.
Nearly the 10th penalty against Maryland. First and 10 from the 41 for West Virginia. Hand off, Smallwood. Good cut by Smallwood. Up to the 47. Jalen Brooks in the double digits for tackles on the day with 10.
And if you're watching West Virginia closely and thinking about the Big 12 this year, this is a good-looking football team. They play very solid defense on all levels we've seen so far in this game. And offensively, we talked about it, about them finding an identity through a real big conference opponent. And they seem to be a team that wants to run the ball and play a little bit to the defense and then get the quarterback involved throwing the ball downfield after you've established this zone read scheme.
Hand off again, Smallwood. Gets 4, sets up 3rd and 1. I'll be honest, I've been doing WVU games.
Officials timeout for an injured player.
A timeout for an injured player. It is Quentin Jefferson down, a defensive tackle for Maryland who has been active. The junior out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. But what I was going to say is, I'll let you know when we come back because we've got a timeout. It's 38-0 West Virginia. Welcome back to FS1 College Football presented by GEICO here in Morgantown, West Virginia, 38-0. The Mountaineers on top. Quentin Jefferson being checked out. Looks like he is all right on the sidelines. It is 3rd down and 2 here for the Mountaineers. Russell Shell is in that tailback. Kept by Howard. And Skylar Howard able to spin forward for the first down on that zone read. And Petros, what I was going to say before the break is I've been doing Mountaineer games since 2012, and this seems to be the most complete team that I've seen from West Virginia. Howard dancing around in the pocket, pumps. Howard escapes again, tucks and runs, and now slides as he comes up about a yard shy of the first down.
Well, what they did to Georgia Southern or Liberty, you don't think too much about. But you look at this score right now, where we are in the game, and yeah, this is a balanced football team. They look to be a balanced football team. I saw them in 2012 with you, and that, of course, is Stedman Bailey and Tavon right. Austin and the great Geno Smith throwing the ball around. But they did not play a lot of defense. In fact, they had a completely different defensive scheme. This is a more defensive team, the 3-3-5 scheme, which is more of a fit here in Morgantown, I think. And they're running the ball.
Second and two, pump fake by Howard. He's in trouble, gets rid of it, complete to Gibson. And Gibson cannot get away from the ankle tackle by Jermaine Carter, a loss of three. But that's the whole thing, is that for the first time, really, we're seeing a legitimate defense. And I realize that Maryland is not looking very good today. And, you know, based on the season, they have a loss to Bowling Green. But you just see the ingredients, the type of talent they have in that secondary for this team. And like you said, that 3-3-5 setup and the running back staple that they have, it's impressive. Third and five. Howard, he gets wrapped up and brought down by Azabuke Ukandu.
Howard's taking some hits here. First with the run on third down, and then he got nailed completing that pass there. And this time Ukandu, a former walk-on from Maryland, the state of Maryland, Towson High School, gets a good hit on it.
Nick O'Toole to punt. William Likely back at the 12. And it's a fake. Running is O'Toole. And O'Toole has the first down. Well, that could open up a little can of worms or a topic of conversation. It's cool to see the fake and to see them pulled off, but you're up 38-0.
Well, and sometimes you run this fake because you look at the Big 12 schedule upcoming for the Mountaineers, and you want your Oklahomas and your Oklahoma States to worry about stopping this kind of play. I don't think it was that great of a spot. I think he got out of bounds a little bit before the stick, but they gave him a favorable spot, and O'Toole, with a prodigious beard, gets to carry the rock.
He could be the Mountaineer with that beard. On first down, the carry for Shell. Gets a couple yards. That really is a quite a beard. I mean,
that's a good punter beard. And you get those beautiful deer skin outfit there that the Mountaineers got on. That's Michael the Mountaineer. I was friends with the previous Mountaineer, John.
Durant in motion.
That buckskin outfit's got to be hot in September, you know?
An overcast day now.
A little mild for him, yeah. He's doing all right today. Me too.
Howard, high throw, looking for Cody Clay.
And if I'm Maryland, I got a problem with that. You know, I don't like that fake punt. I don't like that call. This is a rivalry game. We talked a little bit about how Dana Holgorsen saw the game 2 years ago, the shutout that they had in Baltimore, 37-0. Last year, much more competitive game in College Park that West Virginia edged out Maryland in. But you get the feeling that there's some revenge in the air.
Oh, yeah. Third and eight, taking the shot to the end zone, a jump ball. There's going to be a flag. Looks like offensive pass interference maybe on Devontae Mathis.
Looks like Mathis played a little defense there, and that's not a bad play. Didn't want to jump up for the ball, so just pulled the jersey of Sean Davis. Sean Davis has to recover and finds himself in good position and was setting up to make that pick.
Pass interference. Offense, number 82. 15 yards from the previous spot. Repeat third down.
Not a bad play by Mathis, really.
Officials timeout for an injured player.
The injured player is Sean Davis. He was the one who was thrown to the ground by Devontae Mathis. But he's now up. Looks like he's all right. 3:05 to go here in this third quarter. 38-0 West Virginia with a third and very long when we come back. You can go ziplining. The only campus in the country where you can go ziplining.
Sweet. Looks a little treacherous.
A ropes course. Just make sure you go through the instructions of what you're supposed to do beforehand.
No shortage of trees here in Morgantown. Beautiful setting. And what a great atmosphere for college football. They were ready for today.
Third and 24. Pressure coming. Howard able to just dump it away, and they're going to say incomplete pass to Wendell Smallwood.
You know, we heard a lot about this Maryland pass rush, especially on third down. Yannick Ngakoue, one of those guys, really a third down specialist. Good job of getting after Howard, but you know, like Dana Holgorsen said, this guy's a ball player. He's able to elude that rush and try to make a play out of it. And I'm excited to see how this guy develops in this conference. Lost his helmet.
O'Toole, this time will punt, no fake. William Likely, fair catch. Made at the 15-yard line. Time for a game break. Let's go back to L.A. Jenny, what do you have for us?
Well, Justin, a big game over on Fox. Number 3 TCU visiting Texas Tech, and Patrick Mahomes finds Jakeem Grant for the 45-yard strike. The Red Raiders take the 21-16 lead over the Horned Frogs in the second quarter. And Petros, I want to know, did you do the zip line?
Oh, no, I'm not an adventurous person at all. I barely go outside.
That's why you're so tan.
Yeah.
Well, the new quarterback is in, Dax Garmon. The transfer from Oklahoma State. Brandon Ross in the backfield with him. Garmon stepping up, running with it. And Garmon gets the 21-yard line, picks up 5. Darian Howard was there.
Nothing wrong with that when you're starting out a football game and your legs are cold and you've been watching for a while. Get a little hit going, run the ball, touch the turf, get the feel for the game. Nothing like coming in the huddle when all those guys are breathing hard. You've got a clean uniform.
Garmon didn't like his options. Instead, he takes a sack. Darian Howard, a loss of 3.
This is the third quarterback now that we've seen from Maryland this season. Perry Hills, Caleb Rowe, now Dax Garmon, the Oklahoma State graduate transfer. They're searching for a guy at this point, I think it's pretty safe to say.
Certainly problematic right now for the Terps. There is Perry Hills. And a timeout will be taken by West Virginia.
Charge timeout, West Virginia. A 30-second timeout.
Third and 7 coming up for West Virginia. Our full day of college football caps off tonight with a huge top 20 matchup between 18th-ranked Utah and 13th-ranked Oregon. Coverage begins tonight at 8:30 p.m. Eastern, and it's all on Fox, sponsored by Geico. Thoughts on the game?
Beautiful backs, both of them. Devontae Booker and Royce Freeman. Freeman, just a sophomore. Booker, unbelievable route through Washington State, like 20 JCs to get to Utah. But both really physical big backs. I can't wait to see that game.
Dax Garmon, his first series at quarterback. Facing a 3rd and 7 right now for the Terrapins.
3rd and 7.
A little confusion here for the Mountaineer defense. They get set up. Pressure coming. Garmon gets rid of it. Incomplete. Avery Edwards, the intended receiver, but Garmon had pressure coming from both sides.
And that was the right play call by West Virginia's defense. You saw them all lined up right across the field, right at the sticks. Nobody deep. Little confusion lining up, but They were not going to allow anything underneath them for the first down. The play was really over the top, and Gartman tried to make it, but couldn't.
Nicholas Pritchard on to punt. Gary Jennings, the man back deep now for West Virginia. Jennings will get back to the 49-yard line. It hasn't been the best of days for the offense for Maryland. Turnover after turnover.
Unbelievable play by this really vaunted Mountaineer secondary. Dillon with a pick. Chestnut with a pick. That was Worley with a pick. Carl Joseph, the big star at safety, with a pick. And they took great advantage of Caleb Rose's ability to throw the ball down the field and, unfortunately for Maryland, his ability to throw interceptions. Rowe, a nightmarish day here in West Virginia.
On first down, Russell Schell reverses Fields. Schell being dragged down by his jersey by Anthony Nixon. He does get six, second down and four.
Both these backs for West Virginia have been really impressive today. And other than Schell losing the football, they have a really good rhythm between the two of them. Whether it's Smallwood or Schell, it doesn't seem to make a difference. They both are pretty good inside. They both do a good job of reading their blocks and being patient and pretty physical at the point of attack.
Smallwood this time up the middle. Tripped up at the 37, gets eight, picks up the first down. West Virginia has a chance to have two 100-yard rushers as Wendell Smallwood now has a career-high 136 yards. Russell Schell has 77 yards.
And a lot of it you could give credit to Elijah Wellman, number 28, had a touchdown early in this game. The fullback has really cleared the way. He has guys on roller skates out there. He's delivering a lot of hits, number 28.
Play action. Shot towards the end zone. This one is overthrown by Howard. Intended for Gary Jennings.
And that's the offense. That's what you're going to see from West Virginia. Run the ball, the zone read, and then they're going to take their shots with Howard down the field. And I do have a sneaking suspicion that as this season goes on, and when you get into some tough games and some tough environments in the Big 12, you're going to see Skylar Howard really run the ball. Dana Holgerson's probably going to take the shackles off and tell him, tuck it and go and put your head down, because this is that type of player. He plays with a lot of fire.
Good all-around game for him. The one interception was a tip ball. Smallwood up to the 31, gets six. Jermaine Carter there for his sixth tackle. And that will be the end of the third quarter. 38-0, West Virginia all over Maryland. FS1 College Football presented by GEICO will return after these messages. Welcome back to FS1 College Football presented by GEICO. Start of the fourth quarter here in Morgantown. And guess what? We were shut out in that third quarter. No scoring. But it is 38-0 West Virginia. Looking at a third and four. Skylar Howard going to change the play. Smallwood in the backfield. Howard comes near side, completes the pass. Jordan Thompson. And Thompson able to scamper forward for the first down up to the 19.
Jordan Thompson, one of those players out of Texas who came to West Virginia so he could play against teams in Texas. That's one of those Big 12 advantages that Dana Holgerson has. And that was a really nice job by Skylar Howard. Like you said, Justin, changed the play to a pass. There was a little bit of a rush. He did a good job of retreating a bit and getting rid of the ball to his very, very reliable slot receiver.
High snap, handoff Smallwood. diving forward up to the 16 will get three. Second down and seven.
Smallwood must really love playing football, because every time after he carries the ball, whether it's a four-yard carry or a 10-yard carry, he's got a smile on his face. He's got a great smile. This guy's been having himself a great afternoon.
Pass is zipped out wide. Devontae Mathis. Mathis still on his feet. Down at the three. William likely brought him down, but that was a very well-executed play.
Just off the play action, because Smallwood's been so successful. Good job of everybody coming out to help out, including Jordan Thompson with the blocking out there. And quite simply, the Terps are tired of tackling people. They've been out there a long time, and not a lot of help from the offensive side of the ball. This has been a really tough game for this Maryland defense, and there's a lot of time left in this quarter.
First and goal from the three. Deflected, and that's incomplete.
That play didn't look good from the start. We had a miscommunication in the backfield as far as where the token fake was going to be. Howard tried to recover it by throwing the ball quickly, but incomplete.
Second and goal from the three coming up. Smallwood reaching forward, lunging down at the one. Anthony Nixon, his fifth tackle of the day. Third and goal from the one.
I'd look for the Mountaineers just to keep giving it to Smallwood. He's done a lot of good things. A versatile back who can do most stuff, and he's proven it so far this afternoon.
He's got his fullback in there, Elijah Wellman. They're going to pass. Corner of the end zone. Touchdown. Dekeel Shorts.
What a throw. I mean, Howard really dropped it in there to Shorts, who's on the outside, moved from slot to outside receiver this season. One of the leaders of this wide receiver group, an older guy, a junior, and one of the taller guys they have at 6'1". Really nice play hauling it in. And Howard is not scared to lead these receivers towards the boundary, is he? I mean, really, really confident throwing the ball deep.
Lambert on for the extra point. The first touchdown of the season for Dekeel Shorts. The extra point is good. 45-0. Dekeel Shorts. Nice catch right before the pylon. West Virginia, it's all Mountaineers. Dana Holgorsen apparently needs some energy as his team leads 45-0 in the fourth quarter. But his team is trying to accomplish something that hasn't been done here since 1923. Two shutouts when they win by at least 44 points in the same season.
It's like he's got one of those cans attached to his hand at all times. I've never talked to Dana Holgorsen when he's not drinking one of those energy drinks.
Nick O'Toole will kick off with William Likely back deep. Low kick, and that'll go out of the end zone. Maryland will start at the 25.
Looks like Dax Garmon gonna do it again. Keenan McCardell, great NFL wide receiver, giving him the play.
Wonder how often McCardell runs routes during practice.
Probably not too often, because I wouldn't want to show up the guys that are actually playing.
Garmin in the shotgun. Hand off to Ty Johnson. Johnson stays in bounds. Rick Rump the third with a tackle.
Al-Rashid Benton with the stop.
Second and two here for Maryland. Up the middle again. This time it's Johnson. A flag comes flying in as well. He got the distance for the first down. Question is it going against West Virginia or going against Maryland?
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense number 90. 15 yards from the end of the run. Automatic first down.
Larry Jefferson. Call for the personal foul. This will move the ball into West Virginia territory.
They've been trying to get Johnson the ball here. Just a freshman. One of the guys they're looking to be the future of the run game for the Terps.
Garmin to pass. Over the middle, completes the ball, breaks a couple of tackles, and heading into the end zone for the touchdown, Jarvis Davenport. So much for the shutout.
Nice play by Dax Garmin after a healthy dose of running the football. Just a pretty straight up drop, and they find a hole within that vaunted West Virginia secondary. Starters no longer out there.
And Maryland is going to go for two, trailing 45-6.
Why not? Work your stuff. See what your two-point conversion package looks like on tape and coach it up next week. That's the mode you got to be in right now if you're Randy Edsel.
Wes Brown is in at tailback. DJ Moore in motion. Dax Garmin goes down, sacked.
Xavier Preston, nice play.
The shutout is gone. The touchdown pass to Jarvis Davenport, 45-6, West Virginia. Maryland is on the board, a touchdown. 11:45 to go here in this fourth quarter, 45-6. The defense for West Virginia. The first two games, everyone says, okay, they're not really tough teams. Well, look what they did, averaging coming in, and
better,
what they've done today.
Yeah. Better than against the Liberties and the Georgia Southerns of the world. And you got to say, what a great move getting Tony Gibson in to coordinate this defense and really make the switch to the 3-3-5, something that just seems like such a better fit. And Dana Holgorsen said, you know, I've made mistakes when I first got here as a head coach, and I think that scheme was one of them.
Short kick taken by Dillon. He gets wrapped up at the 15-yard line. Well, let's take a look at our Nissan Heisman watch. And P, who do you have as your top five?
All right, it's still September, but I love Leonard Fournette. I mean, I love it. He is Herschel Walker again. Trevon Boykin's in a war right now. Baker Mayfield's been a lot of fun to watch. We'll see what OU can do throughout the season. Nick Chubb, one of those great SEC backs, along with Leonard Fournette. And there's your sleeper right there. Old string bean Jared Goff at a Marin Catholic High School, throwing the ball for the Cal Bears. He's been a lot of fun to watch, putting up a lot of numbers, a quarterback in the Pac-12 that nobody talks about.
Well, William Kress Jr. is now in at quarterback for West Virginia. On first down, that zone read, Dante Thomas Williams. And Williams will get four, second down and six.
Kress Jr., one of those Baltimore guys, good size, just a redshirt freshman, 6'2", 212 pounds, Dunbar High School in Baltimore. Did you like my Heisman list, Cutcher? Did you think anything was wrong with it?
It's September. I love your Heisman list.
All right, good. I didn't want you to disagree. Is there anybody you want to add?
Like I said, it's September. All right. I don't know. Second down and six. up the middle. It's Thomas Williams again. What I am happy is I'm happy that Rosen was not on the list.
Josh Rosen, the true freshman, yes, throwing the ball for UCLA. Great game in his first game against the Virginia Cavs. A little bit back down to earth on the road at UNLV and looked pretty pedestrian against BYU, but he can make some great throws, and I do believe he's going to be a great one down the road for Jim Mora.
First down, it's Jackie Marcellus. Marcellus up to the 38, gets seven. And I agree with you. I think he's going to be great, too, but it just drove me nuts that everyone, after one game, is saying this guy's going to be the Heisman Trophy winner.
Well, it goes behind all the recruiting hype, and we're talking about one of the best players in the country at a St. John Bosco High School in Bellflower, California. People have been having an eye on him since he was a sophomore. He was a tennis star as a child as well, and he does look the part. A guy like Carson Palmer that I played with, I mean, he's a really good-looking player, but it is going to take some seasoning. You never know, though. He could lead them through the Pac-12. UCLA is very deep.
Nice run here by Crest. Still on his feet as he gets across midfield. The redshirt freshman. An 11-yard run for him. Well, apparently that was a good year for West Virginia because they had the shutouts and now 36 first downs. That ties the record set back in 1923 against that tough Washington and Lee team.
Lee especially that year.
Marcellus. Jermaine Carter, I heard that front four for Washington and Lee that year. I mean, they can get after you.
Yeah. Merciless. But that being said, this is great for the Mountaineers to be able to get some guys involved, get their other quarterback involved. There you see what Skylar Howard was able to do. That's a really good day. The interception, like you said, a tip ball, but a little bit behind him, so a mistake there. But other than that, just a really solid game and his first real test for Dana Holgorsen's new quarterback. I think they really like this guy.
Second and five. Marcellus gets wrapped up in the backfield. Jermaine Carter with his eighth tackle. If you're joining us late, we told you Jermaine Carter, cousins, Vince Carter, Tracy McGrady. Remember Air Canada?
I do.
When Vince was playing with the Raptors.
They were together.
I think yesterday or 2 days ago was the anniversary of his dunk over Frederick Weiss. The 2000 Olympics in Sydney.
Or Frederick, yet to live it down.
Same with the Knicks for drafting him. Quarterback draw. Another first down, and that's the record. 37. A record-setting day here for West Virginia.
And when you run the ball on first and second down and you have a lot of success, like West Virginia has been doing since this game began, you can do that. You can really kind of dink and dunk your way down the field. They've been very disciplined offensively. They haven't made a great deal of mistakes. It's been really impressive today from Dana Holgorsen's guys, needless to say.
Almost 300 yards on the ground, and the pass is zipped in and caught by KJ Myers. I thought it was really interesting speaking with Dana Holgorsen with their quarterback and Skylar Howard, how he's a zone read guy. And now with William Crest, he said all we're recruiting now are zone read quarterbacks. That's what we're going with.
So much of what's being run today in high school. But it's an interesting thing.
Hand off, Jackie Marcellus. The stiff arm. Flag is thrown. Ball comes loose. It's recovered by West Virginia.
Somebody grabbed somebody's face mask. It might be another offensive face mask here.
Holding. Offense number 66. 10 yards from the previous spot. Repeat second down.
Jonathan Haynes. He gets called for the hold. The offensive numbers for West Virginia, almost 600 total yards of offense, almost 300 yards on the ground. So Dana Holgorsen says he wants a balanced attack.
He got it.
You can't get much more balanced than that. 297 running, 301 passing. Second and 13. Crest. Looks like that ball got knocked out, and it was caught by Stone Underwood.
What a moment for the senior. 6'4", 300 pounds, Stone Underwood.
The ball was tipped by a defensive player and caught by an offensive lineman. Third down.
Oh, he's going to watch this 100 times in the tape. Look at how pretty he was. That was almost like the immaculate reception for Franco Harris at the Pittsburgh airport. He pulled it right off the turf. Look at that. What a beautiful, good job, Stone. They're going to show that in the room. Man, that guy's going to have a great week on campus.
And now he can go to all the receivers and say, you guys wear gloves? Yeah.
Let me show you how this is done.
I don't need no stinking gloves.
He's got a wrist brace instead.
6 minutes to go here in Morgantown. And a delay of game.
Delay of game, offense.
You know why?
They were celebrating the catch.
Center was basking in the glory of the catch. Didn't get up over the ball to make the snap. Tell you, it could be just handling success is a big part of football.
It's a big part of life.
Yeah, it is. See if he can collect himself here.
Third and 22. Pressed with plenty of time, airing it out. And it's incomplete. William Likely was trying to chase it down for the interception. Gary Jennings, the intended receiver. And the punt team is coming on. Nick O'Toole to punt. Likely at the 10. The return specialist, we haven't seen much of him today. Fair catch made at the 13. 45-6. It's all West Virginia here. It's all West Virginia coaching staff having some fun along the river. Went down to the New River near Fayetteville, West Virginia, about two and a half hours south of Morgantown. They did some whitewater rafting, and these guys had an absolute blast floating the river. You ever gone whitewater rafting?
Once as a child.
I did it once recently at the Whitewater Center in Charlotte. Oh, my gosh, so much fun.
Well, it's team building, no doubt. I don't know how much you need to do that with your coaching staff. These guys really seem to be together, but it's fun to have a guy like Dana Holgorsen involved because he's a fun guy. He's a fun guy to be around. He's a fun guy to play for, and I think he's a fun guy to play offense for.
I thought it was really interesting when speaking with some of the players from West Virginia. On first down, the handoff to Ross. Is they called him Dana. It wasn't Coach, yeah. Coach Holgorsen, it was just Dana. And there's a relationship that the players have with the coaching staff and they have with the players. And this team, they all said it's the closest team they've ever been a part of. For West Virginia, 41 juniors and seniors on the two deep this year. They've been through so much, they expect big things this year. Garmin on the run, and he will slide. Well, at the beginning of the show, we had three things you need to watch out for. Let's see how good you were.
Well, take the top off. I wanted Maryland to do is get the ball down the field, and Caleb throw it down the field. That didn't happen. He threw four picks. Be explosive. West Virginia did do that, even though they're primarily more of a running team this year. Shelton Gibson with some explosive plays down the field. And for West Virginia's defense, develop the stars. I'll say they were able to do that. Worley, Joseph, all with picks.
Third down and five for Maryland. Garmin, the second quarterback in for the Terps. Pressure coming. Throwing it up, looking for Edatawa. And it's incomplete. And the punt team is coming on. So not the best of days for Maryland, but their fans are loyal. I know Larry Schwartz, an alum from Maryland, still watching despite the fact that his son Zach's wedding is tonight. He's digging it out, watching his Terps.
Well, there's a lot of positivity after the negativity of the loss to Bowling Green and how things really got away from the Terps. They were able to gather themselves against South Florida and get Caleb Rowe going, throwing the ball down the field despite a few picks, but a real step back today.
A punt once again that takes the Maryland bounce down at the 39. We'll be back after this. It's 45-6, West Virginia. Time now for the Dr. Pepper one-of-a-kind play of the game. It was the beautiful pass from Skylar Howard to Shelton Gibson, just dropping it in perfectly for the touchdown. That is the one-of-a-kind Dr. Pepper play of the game.
We hope that cheerleader's okay. She took a pretty good hit and was getting some attention on the sideline. Hopefully she's better.
William Crest Jr. in at quarterback.
Nice to get him some run here. When you have a guy who plays with a chip on his shoulder, much like his head coach said in Skylar Howard, they can have a tendency to make some decisions that can get him hurt. So good to get Crest in here, do some zone read action, get him in the huddle, game feel, watching that clock against the big conference team. Really good stuff, and you can afford to do that when you're really dominating a game the way that West Virginia has done so far.
The handoff is to Thomas Williams, Dante Thomas Williams. For this West Virginia team, next week they're at Oklahoma, then home against Oklahoma State, at Baylor, at TCU, home against Texas Tech. Not exactly a cakewalk of a schedule.
No, it's tough, but that's the Big 12. You know, that's what Dana Holgorsen wants. That's part of the charm of playing at West Virginia now. You go to Oklahoma, but then you have to have a team like Oklahoma State come to Morgantown, and that's not an easy thing to do.
On third down, the high throw from Crest.
A little bit of wind might have affected that ball.
And those teams out of the Big 12.
Double meaning.
Nick O'Toole to punt. William Likely back to return. Into the end zone, and Maryland will have the ball at the 20. Well, Texas Tech leads by 2 over TCU. That game late in the first half.
Still a lot of time left.
A look at the top 10. What's going on around the country? Ohio State leading Western Michigan. Seemed to have that one under control. Michigan State won easily. That TCU Texas Tech game is now 26-28. Garmin trying to dump it off to Wes Brown, incomplete. The question mark for Maryland going forward, because next week, you know, it's Michigan comes to town.
Yes.
A little guy by the name of Jim Harbaugh coming off a victory over BYU today. Then they're at Ohio State versus Penn State, at Iowa versus Wisconsin, at Michigan State. Yeah, Big Ten's a lot of fun, too.
Well, it's not easy. And taking on Michigan after they had a pretty good performance today against BYU, Rudock looked a lot better throwing the ball. It's not going to be easy.
Ball starts. Offense number 58. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
But the question for this Maryland team, okay, Penalties, you got to clean up. Got to do that. You can control that.
You can try. You know, they're just going to have to get back to the drawing board. I mean, they're playing at home. Not everything has been negative. They're going to have to look at this tape and find whatever is a bright spot in it. Probably the early running of Brandon Ross without the fumble, stuff like that, and try to build on it. That's the best you can do.
Etatawu makes the catch on the sideline.
And you could also say that West Virginia probably properly avenged now.
Yes.
Since the blowout shutout loss 2 years ago in Baltimore that stung Dana Holgorsen and his team so much to where it really looked like they were out to prove a point at home. They won in College Park last year, just edged them out, but still bothered by that loss 2 years ago. We heard a lot about that all week.
Third and two now for Maryland. Pressure coming. They get it out. Wes Brown. He's got the first down and much more. Jared Harper finally brings him down after a pickup of 17. By the way, TCU just scored, now up 33-28. A shootout in Lubbock.
Would you expect anything less?
No. Garmin, the check down to Brown. And Brown gets tackled from behind, but pushed forward. Another first down.
And is Dax Garmin going to be the quarterback going forward? He was third string to start the year. Caleb Rowe, obviously, very poor performance today. What's the future for Randy Edsall and his quarterbacks?
Low throw. Today's game being produced by Jeff Gowan, directed by Mitch Riggin. The associate director is Andy Cavanaugh. The broadcast associate is Trevor Hayes. Our technical producer is Matt Benedict. The technical director is Joel Blosser. Our spotter is Ken Trevor. And the men crunching the numbers, Jason Hurd, Mark Cole, Sean Kawila, and Mike Nataro up here in the booth. And there have been a lot of numbers to crunch here today. Coming up on a minute to go. Third and seven. Garmin, incomplete. But guess what? Flags on the play.
Not just the Big 12 flags flying here at Milan Pushkar Stadium. Been a lot of penalties in this game and a lot of undisciplined play, really, from the Maryland Terrapins team.
Holding. Defense number 13. 10 yards from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
That one goes against Mountaineers.
Rasul Douglas.
Just became eligible, did Rasul, from East Orange, New Jersey. Nassau. They got some good size corners here. 6'2", 190. Worley, 6'1", 202. 20 total penalties here.
Pressure coming against Garmin, and he goes down.
Sean Walters out of Hollywood, Florida. I was just in Hollywood, Florida.
Oh, yes.
FAU Miami. Boca Raton.
Should be the last play of the game. Just getting it off. Garmin throws an interception. Kind of fitting. the fifth interception of the day for the West Virginia defense, the sixth turnover of the day for Maryland. Jeremy Tyler with the interception to end it. 45-6, West Virginia defeats Maryland. After this, we'll get you out to Mike Hill for MLB coverage after the break.